This is TWiT.
You've lived your life watching this evolution of, you know, being a kid fascinated with robots and, you know, breaking apart pieces of technology to satisfy your curiosity, to now where we're starting to see things like Boston Dynamics robots, you know, and some of those, it's amazing what some of them can do, but it's also a little unsettling to some people. Drone technology, which I guess at its core is not in and of itself a robot, but it very well could be a flying robot. What are you encouraged by the direction that we're headed? Is this kind of satisfying your vision of the future, or do you think things can be improved? What are your thoughts on kind of the future of robotics based on what we're seeing right now?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot to figure out in robots, and a lot of questions that we'll have to answer. Of course, there's these, you know, quite impressive but far out from a consumer perspective,
sure,
like the stuff that Boston and Dynamics is doing with Atlas and robots like that. You know, I think robots pretty, not even in the distant future. Like, if you think about people and families, the two biggest purchases we have right now are a home and a vehicle.
Yeah.
And we're moving away from vehicles. I was reading last night on the plane that they're going to be soon doing fully autonomous, no safety driver tests in Texas of autonomous cars.
Mm-hmm. I read that too.
And we're close to that, and people, I mean, other than recreation, people aren't going to buy vehicles in the future. It's all just going to be shared, and you're going to call it up, and your autonomous car is going to show up, and you know, you're not going to buy a vehicle. I think robots is going to be that next big purchase. And they're going to get more advanced, right? They got to be bigger, but they're going to be able to fold our laundry and mm-hmm. cook food and, like, clean our house, and we're not going to have to spend our Saturday doing chores like that. We're going to be, unless we want to, right? Maybe they're relaxing for people, but we're going to be able to do the things that we want to do, or spend time with our kids or our families, or go out and go mountain biking or whatever. But you're going to spend, you know, the robot is going to be that big purchase. It's going to be like Rosie from the Jetsons. I think that's where we're going with this space.
Mm-hmm.
But again, Misty is small. She's very cute, friendly, want to see what kind of skills people start to create. And then with future versions, we'll start to, you know, make her a little bit bigger and start to add arms and other stuff. So really, really excited about where consumers, you know, the consumer readiness for a device like Misty is at. And just the amount of technology that you can get now is incredible.
Yeah. Yeah, it really is something. And it's something special to see the Misty 2 here in person and to get to talk with you in person. I really appreciate you coming up to the studio to be here today, because it's one thing to talk to people on Skype. It's another thing entirely in person. I really appreciate that.
Last time I was up here with BB-8, it was super fun. And
yeah,
as soon as I heard about this, I was like, yeah, definitely going up there.
Awesome. And you're going to the Maker Faire this weekend. I wish you the very best of luck showing off the Misty 2.
Yeah, if you're in the Maker Bay, Faire. Come by Maker Faire. Find us and find our booth.
Awesome. That is this weekend. Well, I guess it's today.
Yep.
Yeah, starting today.
Today through Sunday.
Today, the 18th through the 20th. So if you're in the Bay Area, check it out. Right on, Ian. It's really nice talking with you.
Thanks.
Thank you so much. Ian Bernstein, founder and head of product at Misty Robotics.